I'm Leslie Weinmenner. Welcome to Comcast Newsmakers. I'm here today with Representative Woody Burton. He's a Republican from Whiteland. Representative, thank you so much for joining us today.
Thank you for having us.
So I was wondering if you could tell me about what it's like to break in a new governor. I think you've been here for about five governors.
This is my 25th year, and it's been very interesting. I started with Evan Bayh, and we went right on through to Governor Mitch, and now Mike Pence, who I've known for 25 years. And it's interesting because each one of them has their own agenda and they move at a different pace. But, you know, I think we've been blessed because both Democrats and Republicans, I think we've had some good leaders in the governor's mansion over the last 25 years.
So Governor Pence has proposed an income tax cut. Mm-hmm. That was not in the House budget passed by the Republicans. Do you think that will be in the final budget, and where do you stand on a tax cut?
Well, I met with him about this. We all met with him, and I believe that we need to wait until we see the first quarter revenue forecast, because there's things like this Obamacare, which is Medicaid, is going to be an additional 4,000 people on that. I think it's 4,000 people.
400,000.
400,000 people on Medicaid. And we don't know what the costs are going to be yet. And I'm all for, if we can cut the taxes, I'm all for that. But I don't want to cut them this year and then have to come back and raise them next year. So I reassured him that we're supportive of it. And our caucus has talked about it. We have not ruled it out. We just want to wait.
What are some of the other priorities, do you think, this year for the budget?
Huge priority is education. And we've made a lot of changes in the voucher program over the last couple of years in the charter schools. But more importantly, the social environment has changed so much in the education process. I think it's time, we just need to try to keep up with that and make the changes. We had a 16-year-old girl come in and talk about bullying. She tried to kill herself. And so she was fortunate enough to be able to transfer to another school. Wasn't anything wrong with the school she was in, it was the environment. Now she's an AB student and she's happy. And so I think being able to offer choice, but it scares the school teachers because we're talking about moving money and things like that. And so. I think that's probably one of the most controversial issues.
Representative Burton, you were a co-sponsor of the very first bill that Governor Mike Pence signed into law. It was a farming bill. Tell us why that was important.
I think it's important, as you may or may not know, I was one of the advocates who pushed very strongly for doing away with property taxes. Well, we got a cap on them, but the way that the farmers have been taxed, their land values have been jumping all over the place. So we're going back to, I think, 2011 figures, and we're going to freeze them there. Because they have to produce a crop, and they can only pay so much in taxes, and we feel like they were being taxed unfairly.
And also, you have a bill that would help drivers who might not sign their registrations. Tell us about that bill and why it matters.
I get this phone call from this lady, and she had slid through a stoplight on the ice, and the policeman stopped her and says, "Can I see your registration and driver's license?" He went back to the car, and he came back. He said, "Well, I'm not going to give you a ticket for sliding through the intersection because I could see it was icy. However, I am going to cite you because you didn't sign your registration." She went to court and it was $138. Well, I called the judge. I said, "What is going on here?" And he said, "Well, it's the law." And I said, "Well, we're going to fix that." So afterwards, I found that this happened. And incidentally, I went back to my house, checked my driver's registrations, and I hadn't signed because the signatures required on the back. They used to be on the front. And so I went to the BMV and we talked about it. So as a matter of fact, we passed it out of the Senate committee today. All it does is it does not require a signature anymore, because when the police stop a car, they can immediately check the license plate and make sure it's for the right car.
Have you signed your registration now?
Oh, yes. when she called me, I went out and checked mine. I signed them all, but I did not know that. And you know something else? Both parties, if you have two names up there, both have to sign it.
Well, thank you so much for joining us. I'm Leslie Weinbenders with the StateHouseFile.com and Comcast Newsmakers.